Hi guys, in my previous video you saw me make an electric air bike using this DC motor high speed. Although this motor is 24 volts and yet I used it at 48 volts to force it at high speed for high air throw. So today in this video I'm going to remove this motor and use it as a very powerful high current generator. And believe me guys, you will be amazed by the high current output of this generator. And guys, you also saw me make a bicycle generator a few weeks back, and because I'm not using it at present and I need this pulley for this project, so I'm going to remove this generator and take off this pulley for this project. So guys, the generator is finally out of the electric bicycle. Let's extract this pulley. So guys, the trick is quite simple. I'm going to use this wrench, place it like this, and then hammer it at the top. So let's do that. Okay. Yeah, it is coming out, loosening up. Yeah, so guys, it's finally out. Okay, and the generator and motor is still in great condition, no problem at all. Now, although guys, I successfully extracted this pulley from that motor, 180 volts, but there was one calculation problem that there is a minor error and the pulley is not fitting. The shaft is a little thick than the size of the bore on the pulley. Okay, you can see there is a minor difference. So although I can hammer it, but I'm not going to take the risk on the body of the motor. So I'm planning on thinning this shaft for best alignment, little thinning. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, so guys, for that I'm going to use this laptop charger, 15 volts. And because this motor takes in a huge startup current, so I'm going to give this DC supply in pulses at first. So let's connect the first terminal. Yeah, the first terminal has been connected. Now comes the second one. Now you will see when I will connect it, it won't start. You can see, yeah, it takes some time to attain full speed. Now this is the metal sandpaper that I'm going to use to thin the shaft a little. Okay, let's do that. Yeah, it's very hot. A little more. Let's try it now. Yeah, you see, it is going inside. A little more thinning and we are through the shaft with perfect alignment. Okay, so guys, as you can see that I have removed the shaft from this motor. So guys, here as you can see, I have cut a little part of this shaft with the grinder to give gaps, and this gap is very useful. You can see that these little metal gaps in the shaft. So to lock this better, I have given this gap. Now I'm going to fill in glue and then place it like this. So the glue will lock with the gaps in this and with this shaft. So at present it is free running. So I'm going to fill this with glue and then insert this shaft and then leave it for some time so that the glue dries up. Yeah, I've filled it with this. Now let's insert the shaft. It's coming out. I have to keep it like this for some time. Okay, so guys, now this DC motor is ready to be used as a generator. So let's test it with a multimeter. Pointing it towards 20 volts DC mode first. Okay, so first I'm going to rotate the shaft with my hands and let's see the voltage. Okay, opposite. So the maximum I could do was 3.85. Let's do some rope rotation. Okay, watch the screen. Okay, once again. Go. 17.22 volts. And guys, now comes the current measurement. Pointing it towards 10 amperes mode. Now guys, the current is going to be high because this is a high current motor. Maximum hand rotation amps was 1.70, almost 2 amperes. Let's try the rope rotation. Keep watching the screen. Yeah, I put a really little power because I knew that the current was going to be high and this can support only 10 amps and not more than that. Otherwise, the meter can get damaged. If you want, I can take it to 10 amperes. Okay, so I'm going to take it to 10 amperes and as soon as it displays 10 or more amps, I'm going to stop to protect the meter. Okay, go. 9.45. Okay, this I'm planning on pulling it even harder. 10.07 amperes, as I said. Okay, so guys, let's mount it on the e-bike and see how much volts I can generate. So this is going to be a little up, so I have to keep something below it. So I'm going to use the metal chips. Yeah, perfectly aligned. Yeah, it's pretty steady now. Let's connect the belt. Okay, so guys, here as you can see, I have connected the multimeter at 20 volts DC mode. And now I'm going to generate some voltage. And you should see it displayed on the screen. So guys, as you saw that the voltage was pretty good. It was generating somewhere around 14 to 15 volts, which was best for charging our car batteries or inverter batteries, 12 volts. So guys, here as you can see, I have connected this 12 volts car headlamp bulb to this motor directly. Let's see if it glows. You can see it was glowing pretty good. So guys, my initial bicycle project was just a demonstration for you people to understand, but this machine I'm actually going to use it to power up my lab inverter. And guys, the high current output from this dynamo will be used to charge this 35 amperes car battery. Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit that bell icon for similar video notifications. Also, do comment on what else you would like me to add to this present video. Best regards, Electron.